Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse shoe review of the Nike Air Max Wildcard. Offering comfortable support in an affordable package, Nike presents the Air Max Wildcard. Featuring Air Max unit in the heel, a premium insole, and a Lunalon firm midsole, the Wildcard feels soft and plush underfoot. The one-piece upper provides a secure fit and prevents unnecessary stretching for added support. Integrated crash pads on the outsoles create a smooth heel-to-toe transition. The outsole wraps up on the medial side for added durability on lateral slides and toe drag. The shoe fits slightly short, has a narrow width, and has a slightly low arch. The Air Max Wildcards are good to go right out of the box with no break-in required. First up today, we have Eric. What did you think of these Air Max Wildcards?
Yeah, at first the fit out of the box was a little bit snug for me. Once I wore these shoes for about a week, they did tend to open up a little bit. I did enjoy the one-piece upper of the shoe. The shoe really locked my feet in. I felt really secure, especially on lateral movement. It was really stable, and I really enjoyed the shoe from that aspect. The shoe was quite cushioned between the foam insole and the Air Max technology. This is one of the most comfortable shoes, cushion-wise, that I've worn, so that's really nice. From a durability standpoint, these didn't last me too long, roughly around 10 hours before I saw a lot of balding on the shoe, which was a little bit of an issue for me. And the traction for me as well, that outsole is pretty, it's not exactly sticky, but the medial side, the outsole wraps up a little higher than I'm used to. So when I was sliding, making aggressive movements, it tended to stop me from sliding and maximizing my movement that way, which is like how I tend to maximize my movement when I'm sliding. So this isn't a perfect option for me as far as movement is concerned, but if you do like to take sudden stops, this is definitely good for you. Overall, I like the cosmetic. It's really nice in that department. And if you guys are looking for a narrow shoe with a good amount of cushion, I think you should definitely give this shoe a try.
Next up, we have Troy. Now, Troy, like me, you have somewhat of a narrow foot. How did the Air Max Wildcard work out for you?
Yeah, the overall profile of this shoe worked really well for my foot type, kind of being on the slimmer side of medium. That said, I did have a bit of a break-in with the upper material. So I think the first three or four times I wore these shoes, it was before I took them on court just wearing casually. And that was mostly because I really like how they look. Kind of have that like basketball shoe kind of style look to them. So I really like how they look, but yeah, wearing them before I took them to court, there was a few days where I was wearing them around, walking around in them, and throughout the day I kind of had to take them off just because right around the widest part of my foot before my toes start, that's where I was getting a little bit of restriction, a little bit of cramping. But after walking around in them for a few days, taking them down to the court, I really had no issues from then on forward. I really liked the cushion, talking about the insole and midsole combination. I definitely could feel the Max Air unit in the heel. When you land on your heels, it's very plush. Forefoot cushioning, it wasn't as responsive or soft as maybe the Zoom Nike Air Zoom Zero, but it was plenty enough for me to support my weight and whatnot when I was on the balls of my feet. So liked it from that aspect. The upper material is pretty firm, not very breathable, so I didn't get very good ventilation. They ran a little hot, not that it was an issue for us in this indoor court, but they do run a little hot, but I felt like it did a good job of support. Lateral movement, it kept my foot locked in place. Most aspects of the shoe I really liked. I did find that the durability was a little low. I went through the outsole pretty fast, and I don't typically wear through my shoes as much as I used to, but that would be the only knock, would be the durability and some lack of ventilation.
Next up we have Sean. Now Sean, you probably struggled the most with the fit and performance of this shoe. Tell us about it.
Yeah, unfortunately this was a little bit of a rough play test for me. I really enjoyed the Zoom Zero, but I felt like that shoe outperformed this takedown in all the key areas for me. The biggest disappointment for me was definitely the durability. I was noticing balding after just one set of doubles when I first took it out. What that did translate to for me though was I didn't really like the traction when I initially put them on. It was a little sticky for me. But then when it started balding, I noticed it was a little smoother so I could slide a little bit in my shots. So that improved as the playtest went on. The fit of the shoe was a little snug. I normally kind of I've been going down to a size 9, but there was no way I was gonna make that work, so I had to go up to a 9.5, but even when I went up, I still felt some pinching around my pinky toe. And then I kind of noticed I took the insole out and put my foot in, and the shoe felt really wide actually. So I was really surprised. I think the insole is contributing to that snug fit. It wraps way up around the side of my foot. And I also thought the shoe was extremely plush, but then when I took out the insole, it felt a lot less padded underfoot, and I noticed that the insole was really thick. So I think that's contributing for most of that plush feel. The one thing I think the shoe does really well, like the Zoom Zero, is it has that full canvas upper, and I think that does a really good job of supporting my movement laterally, side to side. But unfortunately, it was running a little bit hot, especially when I took it outside. It wasn't too big of an issue on the indoor court in here, but outside, my feet were getting a little bit swampy. Overall, I just really prefer the Zoom Zero. I think its strengths stand out a lot more and it has less weaknesses for me. But if you're the type of player that likes the Zoom Zero, but isn't that worried about durability and wants a lower price point, maybe you should check this one out.
I was also on the playtest team for this shoe, and I have probably the narrowest foot on the entire squad, and so I found the fit to work really well for me. I did go up a half size just to get the right length fit, but width-wise, I felt really dialed in. The insole, as Sean was just mentioning, does wrap up on the lateral side, so around the pinky toe, it flares up there, and I really like that because it gave my foot lots of cushioning when I came to an abrupt lateral stop. My foot felt really protected. The uppers also did a really good job of holding my feet and stopping them from ballooning out over the midsole and outsole. So I felt very secure on those lateral stops. And also the durability is not great. It's probably my biggest knock on this shoe is the durability. But once it did wear down, I did prefer, also as Sean mentioned, the traction was a little bit more give to it as it smoothed out. And so I was able to slide out of shots nicely and also pivot a little quicker without the outsole getting hung up on the court. Probably the biggest challenge for me was getting my foot in the shoe. The insole is very sticky, and so I had a tendency to try and pull the socks back over and under my toes as I was sliding my foot in. But once I was in, laced up, I really enjoyed playing in the shoe. Felt super light and fast out on the court, and I felt like I was really moving at maximum speed in this one. That's all we got for this version of the Tennis Warehouse Shoe Review. Be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Shoe Rip, or Tennis Only for more on the Nike Air Max Wild Cards.